So today we're going to multiply our polynomials for 5.3 in MAT1033. Again, I really would like you to pause it and try to work on them, but please write down your notes. A lot of you are of the format that you really need to actually take notes to have it absorbed. And you can write some of the words down that I use as well, or some of the actual helpful hints that you may need. So the first problems we're going to do are multiplying monomials, which, remember, monomials means one term. This is actually something you did in 5.1. So we are going to use the commutative property to multiply the coefficients together, and then we're going to, remember, use the property of my product rule, which says if I have the same base multiply together, I keep the base and I add the exponents. So here, I have a negative 2 times a negative 8, and I have y cubed times a y to the 4th. I'm going to show that step once, because after this we're going to try to do it in our head. So we get a positive 16, y to the 7th. On number 2, 5 times 5 is 25. Add our exponents, be careful, 3 plus 3 is 6. If you find yourself multiplying instead, take the extra step and write it as addition. Number 3, we now have 3 different pieces. So 3 times 6 is 18. If it helps, put a 1 there. We have 2 plus 1, which gives me y cubed. And we have 3 plus 4, which gives me z to the 7th. That's my answer. Number 4, negative 4 times 5 is a negative 20. Add my exponents of my m's. 3 plus 2 gives me 5. Number 5, a negative 12 times a negative 9. Be careful, just do it in your calculator to double check, especially for a test. We have an r to the 4th and an r to the 1st, so we have r to the 5th. And there's nothing to combine with the s, so it comes over. So we're now going to multiply a monomial times a binomial. And in this case, then, we are going to use a distributive property. So we have, again, a 2x times a negative x plus 2x times 5. Now, I'm, again, going to show that step on my first problem, but after that, I want you to just go ahead and distribute it out. So I get a negative 2x squared plus 10x. So I'm going to do a number 7, same thing. 3 times 5 is 15. Add my exponents for my p, so I get p to the 6th. Go to my second term. 2 times 3 is 6. I get 2 plus 2 for my exponents, so that gives me p to the 4th. Negative 21, p squared. If the original problem you couldn't add anything inside the parentheses, your final answer, you should not be able to add anything as well. Going to my binomial times my binomial. This is a problem where they're not going to talk about FOILing until the next section, but I know most of you use it anyway, so I recommend using it now. However, when you click the Help Me Solve This, they're going to use it, just talk about using the distributive property twice. FOILing means first, outer, inner, last. I like to draw arrows. So my first means 4a times 3a, which is 12a squared. My outer is 4a times 6, which gives me 24a. My inner is a negative 15a, and my last is a negative 30. Double check your signs. Really easy to make a mistake there. And not all the times, but often, you can add the two middle terms together. So I get 12a squared. Remember, we keep the variable. 24 minus 15. So on number 9, you're still FOILing as well. So you multiply the first together, which gives you the 14x cubed. You multiply the outer together, which gives you the 12x squared. Multiply the inner, which is minus 7x. Multiply the last, which is a minus 6. Scan it. There are no like terms to add together. It is in descending order, so that is my answer. So So the last type that we're going to see in this section is going to be multiplying. The last part we're going to look at is multiplying polynomials times polynomials, meaning it doesn't matter what size they are. I will personally recommend that if you look at a problem and you see that you have a smaller polynomial at the end, I tend to always move it to the beginning, so you can look at how I rewrote example 10 and 11. You will get the same answer either way. I just find it's easier to work with it using the distributive property if the smaller amount of terms polynomial is in the front. Because the rule says, take each member of the first parentheses times the whole second parentheses. So notice I put the 2a in the minus 5. And now I'm going to bring down the whole second parentheses. So the 5a cubed minus the 6a squared plus the 2a minus the 3 all come down. And now I'm going to use the distributive property for the second time and multiply. So this is going to give me a 10a to the fourth minus 12a squared plus 4a squared minus 6a. Before I go any further, I'm going to double check my exponents and actually see I just caught myself because I shouldn't be able to add these two together. So I just caught a careless mistake there. That should have been a 12a cubed. And I'm going to distribute the next piece of my first parentheses, which is the minus 5 from my binomial. And when I distribute here, I'm actually going to go ahead and put them together. Meaning I'm going to go ahead and put underneath any like terms just to make the next step easier. So I have a minus 25a cubed plus 30a squared minus 10a plus 15. Before I go any further, especially check your signs. Minus, positive, minus, positive. So now I can collect like terms. If you didn't do it in this format of vertical form, it's fine. Just be careful to collect the like terms together. So because I did it in the vertical format, I can add like terms. Minus 37a cubed plus 34a squared minus 16a plus 15. And so by doing it in that format that I just did it in, I actually put it in descending order at the same time of collecting like terms. That's my solution. But if you're doing this type of problem especially, please slow down. Double check your signs, your each step, because it's super, super easy to make one careless mistake and the whole problem is wrong in my math lab. So same idea here for the last problem. I rearranged it and now I'm going to take each member of the first parentheses times the whole second parentheses. So I'm going to bring down the x cubed plus x squared plus x plus 1. And now I'm going to distribute again. So the 5x goes to all four terms in that first parenthesis. So I get 5x to the fourth plus 5x cubed plus 5x squared plus 5x. Again, be very careful of this minus sign. So I'm going to go ahead and do it in a vertical format. So I have a minus 3x cubed, a minus 3x squared, a minus 3x, and a minus 3. In this case, the minus would go to each piece. And now I'm going to add down. It gives me 5x to the fourth plus 2x cubed plus 2x squared plus 2x minus 3. As long as I didn't make any careless mistakes, that is my answer.